Welcome to the Tarantula Collective. My name is Richard, and today I need to rehouse my Diplura species Rurinabok. Now, don't quote me on that pronunciation because I have no idea if that's anywhere close. But this is a curtain web spider from Bolivia. It hasn't really outgrown its enclosure, but it was an old temporary enclosure I was using. It's looking a little cramped. It's webbed the heck out of the entire thing. And I just got in this new enclosure from Tarantula Cribs, and I just really think this would be an awesome spider to display in this new enclosure. Now, this spider did mold about a week or two ago. So it's looking a little thin, but they are a gorgeous species that look very similar to tarantulas, but technically they're not a tarantula. Now, I searched all around for some reliable information on the potency of their venom. They are a New World spider, but I couldn't find anything scientific that seemed reliable other than just some anecdotal evidence, people posting comments that they assume it would be more powerful than a tarantula. But I do know one thing, and it's that this spider is super quick. So I gotta be very careful in this rehousing. So to start off, let's just get its new enclosure set up. Now, I set up this spider essentially like a GBB, except the green bottle blue likes an aired enclosure, so dry substrate, but this spider I keep on slightly damp substrate. So I'll be using jungle mix for the substrate, but pretty much anything would work. Right now it's on cocoa fiber, and part of the reason I want to do this rehouse is because I've been having some issues with mold growing in the cocoa fiber, and I think it'll do a lot better in the jungle mix. When I set the first enclosure for this spider, I actually anticipated it to do a little bit more burrowing than it has. So I filled that enclosure up about halfway with substrate. And it burrowed a little bit, but mainly what it did is just build webs all over the top and spends all of its time hanging on its web tunnels. So I'm not going to use as much substrate in this enclosure. So I filled up the enclosure about a quarter to a third with substrate, and now I am going to just kind of dampen it all down. And I'm gonna add a little bit of sphagnum moss to help kind of retain some of that moisture. All right, now I'm just gonna set it up like I would a Chromatopelma cynopubescens. So I'm gonna give it plenty of sticks and decorations and stuff like that for it to use as anchor points. So I've got this little stick here and a whole bunch of cork bark. And of course, a skull. Fun part, let's get this spider out of its old enclosure and put it in its new enclosure. As you can see, this thing is a pretty heavy webber. It's webbed the heck out of this enclosure. And to be honest, I'm not entirely sure how I'm gonna get it out of here. Well, it rehouses itself. This is a very easy spider to keep. They have some beautiful webbing. You just need to make sure you give it plenty of anchor points so it can web and keep that substrate slightly damp. Now, I did include a water dish. I just used one of these little plastic cups, but you can use pretty much anything. I've never actually seen mine drink. Usually it just drinks its water off its webs, but I figured I'd give it a water dish. I'm sure it'll web it over, but at least until it does, it'll have access to fresh water. Now, I feed mine a couple of medium crickets every other week. It doesn't eat a whole lot, and I base that mainly on its abdomen size because it'll get looking really plump. But the cool thing about this spider is that once it's webbed everything up and it's feeling comfortable in its enclosure, it'll spend a lot of time just sitting right out on top of its webbing. But if you disturb it at all, like if it hears any loud noises or you touch the enclosure, you can almost guarantee it's gonna run and dive into one of its tunnels. Now, I wanna say thanks to Tarantula Cribs for sending me out this awesome enclosure and for being such a huge supporter of the channel. I really appreciate it. If you wanna see more rehousing videos, I got a whole playlist right here you can watch. And if you haven't already, you should definitely check out this video, which is the top 5 reptiles for tarantula keepers with Wiccan's Wicked Reptiles. As always, I appreciate you watching. Subscribe if you wanna see more. Thanks for buying Tarantula Collective merchandise, and I will see you this Tuesday.